սարկումը դրված է բարձր մակարդակի վրա։ Գրանցվելով Tower Pharmacy, դուք հեռու եք մնում բոլոր տեսակ ուշացումներից, դեղերի պակասություններից և ամենակարևորը ժամանակի աննպատակ կորստից։ Ձեր դեղերը ճիշտ ժամանակին կլինեն ձեր տանը։ Գրանցվելով Tower Pharmacy, դուք կլինեք անհոգ և առողջ։ Դե ուրեմն ապրեք առողջ։ Tower Pharmacy, մենք գտնում ենք Գլենոքս և Վերդուգո փողոցների հատման կետում։ Classic Pastry. Այս գեղեցիկ խանութը 15 տարուց ավել աշխատում է 39-10 Ֆութիլ Բուլվարդ հասցեում, Լակրասենտա քաղաքում։ Պատահական չէ, որ խանութը կոչվում է Classic. Այստեղ բոլոր խմորեղենները անչափահամեղ են, թարմ և բազմատեսակ, Classic դիզայնով պատրաստված։ Սա է պատճառը, որ բոլորը ճանաչում են այս խանութը։ Այսօր արդեն բացվել են նոր մասնաճյուղ բրբանկում 130 Սաուդ Գլենոքս և Օլիվ փողոցների խաչմերուկին, Chevron բենզոկայանի հարևանությամբ։ Օգտվեք այս հրաշալի
Բարի երեկո, սիրելի արնագիստներ, ինչպես ամեն շաբաթ երեկո միանալու եթերով, այսօր մի չարնագենք մեր հաղորդումը։ Այսօր մենք խոսենք հայերեն եւ անգլերեն, որովհետեւ մեր հյուրերը ամերիկացի են եւ ավելի անգլերենով մենք խոսվի։ Բայց նախքան անցնեմ հայդակրին, շատ հրադապ հարց մը գա, մենք առաջ փասադրեմ հայերեն, ապա մենք խոսենք անգլերեն։ Մեմի եւս մի քանի ժամ առաջ, մոտավորապես 2 ժամ առաջ Kessab-ին վրա մեծ հարցագում մի եղած է, մեծ ռմփակոծում մի եղած է, եւ այդ վիդեոն կարծեմ թե տվի, եթե գրնանք մեկ վարյան այդ վիդեոն ցույց տալ, այս վիդեոյի մեջ պիտի տեսնակ Kessab-ի վրայի հարցագումը ջիհադիստներու ճշտամիներու կողմեն, որոնք իրենք նկարած են հարցագումը, եւ քիչ վերջի պիտի տանք թիվեր, եթե ցայնը գրնանք մտի գնան։
They're just shooting anybody. That's how they celebrate the massacres by killing more people.
Ավասիկ դեսանք այդ փոքր վիդեոն, ավելի վիդեոներ մի քանի քիչ վերջը, ապրիլ 24-ի EV երեգո նախքան ապրիլ 24-ի commemoration-ը լա, դեսանք մեմևս թուրքական գոմեն ռմփակոծումներ կան ջիհադիստներուն Kessab-ի վրա։ Եվ մեմևս իրենք իրենց ոճիրը կկործեն ապրիլ 24-ի օրով։ Եվ այդ օրամար մենք պետք է հերացայնենք բոլորով State Department-ին, ձեր բոլորին TV-ը բիդի, բոլորի դա TV-ը բիդի դամ 202-647-6575, 202-647-6575 Human Rights Decision Division հերացայնեցեք եւ ծեր complaint-ը դրեք, որ Թուրքիո կողմեն, Թուրքիան եւ իրենց ISIS զինվորները, Ջաբհաթը Նասրան ջեհադիստները գրմփակոծեն գոր հայկական քյուղը մեմ եւս։ Այդուհամար մենք պետք է մեր ցայնը բարձրացնենք ավելի բարձր, նամանավանդ ապրիլ 24-ի օրով, որ այս հիշատակի օրը Memorial Day-ով մեմ եւս ոչրակորձները ոչրակորձեն եւ Թրամփի պես անձնավորություններ Ձեզ բախտապար գերացանեն այդպիսի terroristներու Էրդողանին եւ congratulations-ներ գսեն, գշնորհավորեն այդ մարդասպաներուն։ Հետաքրքիր է իրենը, շատ ասիկա, շատ հետաքրքիր մտնոլորտ մնա այլևս կդեստան։ Եվ այդ առումով, որովհետեւ genocide-ի մասին մենք խոսեինք այսօր, մեր ստուդիոյի մեջ հրավիրեցինք նախկին congressman Texas-ի եւ foreign affairs committee-ի նախակահ Steve Stockman, thank you, Steve, for coming to you. I was going to say United States, but Los Angeles. You're in the United States.
Well, this is a foreign country.
And being with us one more time on the eve of Armenian Genocide commemoration. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here, Matthew. And as you see, you were with me when I received the phone call.
This is breaking news.
Right.
This is something that, you know, Bedros, you know how evil succeeds? When good men do nothing.
Right.
And we have a lot of good men and good women watching this show. They need to call that number. 202, what is it again?
647-6575.
Grab your pen and paper, write it down before the end of the show. He'll say it again. But you need to get involved. There are real people dying. You're here in America. You're very safe. Or some of you are probably in Canada and around the world. But you're in a safe place where you can take action. And I just ask us, as an American and you as an American, that you speak up for the people who are being killed.
And you saw the video right in the middle of the city on the buildings.
Undiscriminately, just right. Lobbing missiles.
It's coming from Turkey, the same Turkey that a few days ago, Trump, we all voted for Trump because we thought he was going to make a difference. He congratulated a terrorist dictator called Erdogan. That was amazing. I mean, that was shocking to everybody.
Yeah, and a lot of the Turks, by the way, had to flee Turkey. They're, right. They're being locked up. I would argue, and some would argue, that coup was not necessarily a coup. It was right. Orchestrated because whoever runs a coup didn't do a very good
right.
job.
So they did that in order to...
I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of people that talk like that. There's some evidence to that. I'm just really suspicious about that whole thing.
And at the eve of the genocide, the next day they were in that village, Kessab, little town of Kessab, which is historic Armenian land, Kilikia. It's right now it's in Syria. From the other side of the border, Turkish border, as we see, they took their picture. They took their own video and showing it on their side. They're praising their Allah for bombing innocent people right on the eve of the genocide that it was to be commemorated tomorrow.
Yeah.
And that's basically because nobody's doing anything.
Yeah.
Countries like United States and big countries, I guess they care less if innocent people are killed.
Yeah, but there's a difference here now. We're in a relatively safe area. We are in a safe area. We have the modern techniques of a telephone is in your pocket and in other places.
Right.
And I think it's as important to tomorrow or Monday rather to call and express your opinion. You can always be silent. That's how things happen.
Right.
That's how genocide happens. Be silent. I don't
That's why we need to call that number.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Matthew, you saw the video also.
You know, the video is very, very shocking just because, you know, Syria is my home country to begin with. Especially for Turkey to take action like this on the eve of the Armenian genocide, that just goes to show you that they are a murderous country, that the dictator who's running the country now that Trump decided to praise and congratulate needs to be dealt with on the international level. You know, the U.S. always talks about we need to take out dictators, we need to liberate the lands and mm-hmm. things like that and make a democracy. Where's the democracy in Turkey, number one? Number two, this dictator himself that Trump so-called called, he's murdering people in Syria on a daily basis. He's the one behind the orchestration of the bombings, the mass weapons to ISIS, and... Mm-hmm. When our president decides to pick up the phone and congratulate somebody like that,
right.
Not only as an American does it bother me, but as a Syrian it bothers me.
So, by the way.
Right, and it's horrendous. And we as Americans, we as Arabs, Armenians, we need to get up and call this number, call the State Department.
Say in Arabic, by the way, for our Arabic friends. Can you do that?
I will. Yeah.
Okay. Here.
Read the we need to call the State Department. To the 202-647-6575 and ask for the Human Rights Division, or ask for any division for that matter, to speak to somebody to voice your complaints that somebody needs to stop Turkey, somebody needs to get the international union involved and basically charge them with murderous acts, not just back in the past, but now.
Say the number in Arabic for me, please.
Now,
can you do that or not?
Telephone بالعربي مشان تحكوا انتوا بالعربي لان سوريا سوريا حرام تعمل فينا هيك اوكي سو لازم تحكوا ستيت ديبارتمنت تبع امريكا رقم تليفون 202-647-6575 حكوون هار تنين وقولوا لازم تركي توقف شو عم تعمل بسوريا وتترك بلادنا مثل ما عملوا بارمينيا بدهم يعملوا بسوريا حاجي بقى اوكي سو بليز 6-4-7-6-5-7-5.
Okay, so that's the number. We said it in
three English, languages. Armenian, and Arabic.
And I will say it in Armenian. Gernak heratsaynel 202 647 6575 State Department-ի թիվն է եւ ծեր քանկարդը գրնակ ներկայացնել այս վիդեոն փաստ մնեմ որ ահա վասի կրմփակոցեն որ քեսաբը եւ պիտի չի գնան ռմփակոցելը մեկ հիշեր առաջ ապրիլ 24-ին որ commemoration մը պետք է լա քեսաբի մեջ այդ իրենց մեջ վախ կուզեն մտցնել որ այդ commemoration-ը չնեն genocide-ի թեմ
but tell them to be respectful but be firm
yeah պետք է հարկանքովը լա եւ
Yeah, don't cuss them out or yell at them like that.
How young Bek Chiga? But you know, it's very interesting that all those years passed, all of a sudden, Turkey rises again from 1923 to now. They rise constantly, history is repeating itself, and Turkey has always committed genocides all around the world. You, as a former congressman, I want to know. How does the U.S. see all this and not speak? Is there a big Turkish lobby? Is that why?
A very big Turkish lobby, in fact. And by the way, Turkey has some people that are opposed to the current government. Let me make that clear. And are very good friends of mine. So, yeah, the lobby and some of the top countries are Israel, Turkey, of course, China, are some of the top countries lobbying. And frankly, the Armenians... Don't lobby at all that I know of. I was on foreign affairs, and you'd think I'd heard from them once or twice, but never. But the Turks, I probably heard from literally three or four times a week, and they had different functions to go to. They're very strong on the Hill, and that's why it's important that I think that there needs to be something the way the Turks. The Turks have a house there. They have a bunch of different stuff. Plus, they have a strong lobbying presence, and I don't know the political situation that's going on, but I can just tell you that there needs to be a better effort to get out the other side
to make the voice.
Yeah, yeah. Louder. You have an Armenian caucus, but it's not. I wouldn't say it's as active as the Israelis, or the Chinese, or the Turks, and you don't have to be like for instance, Azerbaijan has a very effective one, and they're not that big. You don't have to be a big country to have an effective lobbying.
How do you get that big? With money?
Well, yeah, you get contributions and you build on it. But you have to be there. It's kind of like playing a football game. You have to be on the field.
Right.
If you're not on the field, you're not going to win the game. And I don't see an effective team by Armenia on the field. Is the best way to put it.
By Armenians, basically.
Right. Yeah, they're not on the field at all. Be frank. I'm not trying to be rude. I'm just being frank.
Well, we can make a change on that. I'm sure people like to hear that. But I wanna get back to what we're seeing right now: attack on Christianity in Middle East. But at the same token, there is attack on Christianity here in the United States also. And I wanna elaborate on that a little bit also because we're coming closer to genocide, we're at the eve of the genocide. Monday is the commemoration day, and
By the way, are you having a celebration or not celebration? Commemoration.
Commemoration in front of the Turkish embassy. Yes, at 12
o'clock.
What
time? Noon.
Noon. 12 o'clock.
So someone can grab a bite to eat, then show up at noon.
At the Turkish embassy or consul general
and where
on
is
Wilshire
that?
Boulevard.
Wilshire.
Majority of Armenians know where it is. And they can be there at 12 o'clock, and they have to voice their opinion. I know sometimes people say it's an empty building and there is nothing happening in the building, but then the media is what it counts, right? What would you say about those protests? Do we need to do it?
Oh, listen, we're protesting science.
Right. Oh, there was a protest science today.
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, we're in the mood for protesting, apparently, but... No, I think this is a much more serious issue than what they protested earlier today. And this issue, frankly, there's a lot of Turks inside that are Muslims that want to see you protest. It's not just Christians that want to see you. The freedoms we're losing around the world, whether it's Russia or Armenia, Western Armenia or Turkey, all around the world, we're seeing our freedoms erode, and the reason they're eroding is because we're not standing up and fighting for our individual rights.
Right. And what would you say about the historic event that took place, the genocide, and we have currently a movie coming out, came out.
It's out right now.
Right.
If you can listen for a moment on this, there's a movie made about Armenia. Now, some argue it's good or bad, but if you want another movie made about Armenia, you need to go watch this movie. There was only 200,000 tickets sold, which is relatively low. And you need to take friends and go see it. Now, I can't vouch for it. I myself want to see it tomorrow or soon this week. And it's because if you want more movies made like this or about Armenia, we need to promote it and help it out. But I would suggest that if you have the time to go down and see it, and what's it called?
The Promise.
The Promise. It's a period movie. It's from 1915. But it's also, I think it starts in 1914. I'm not sure.
Right.
But I think
it's about the genocide.
Yeah, right. But I think it's 1914. But it's also got a love story, and it kind of make the movie, I guess, to tie it together.
And the Turks are trying to
stop it.
Yeah. They've attacked so much on media that they've put so much negativity on it. And it's all paid people that actually got paid to go and blast this movie. I've known people that went and watched it. I haven't watched it either myself.
Did they like it?
They loved it. I actually was seeing on Facebook a woman said, I'm still crying in my car about it.
Right.
It's we have to get up and go watch it and not listen to the social media and negativities. They're all Turkish people. They're all robo people that just go on a computer and just type
paid
it up.
Paid by Turkey.
Of course. And it's basically to silence the Armenians from actually giving the truth out. And Turkey cannot escape from the truth. There's been so much mounting evidence that what took place there, and it's a murderous crime. I mean, I'm surprised that we're not able to actually start prosecuting or at least get an apology from Turkey, something to acknowledge the fact. We're not saying this government right now did it, but we're saying at least acknowledge your ancestors had some part to do this.
I'd like to say, though, that throughout, this is a great show because everything you're doing is taking action.
Right.
You can sit back and watch reruns of Gilligan's Island. That's fine. I could watch Beverly Hillbillies or whatever. I guess I'm aging myself. But this is something you can watch this show tonight. You can actually make a difference. And I personally know that if you get a few phone calls into the State Department about this and maybe some demonstrations tomorrow or Monday, we can get this on the map and people talking about it.
Okay. I'm getting a phone call from Kessab right now.
This is amazing. You're actually getting calls from
Right
Syria.
Now I'm getting phone calls, Kessab. I don't want to...
But can you say it in Armenian?
Yes. Norhima inzi kesaben heratsayin gukagor vor bidi khosim patchem uzer shoy zamanak khosim shat vat vijak ka esor kesavi mech rampagozumner gan yev jogovurte vakhi mech em em yevs tsezi herakhositiv the state departmentin polorat gernak heratsaynel Steve Stockman ir engernerun bavaganin message ghrgets arten hostegen Telefon intiv gernak heratsaynel State Department-in 202-647-6575 202-647-6575 եւ բոլորը ցեր քանքադը ներկայացեք առանց չղայնության ցեր քանքադը ներկայացեք ասեք ինչ կթարնա որ այդտեղը քիչ մ առաջ վիդեոն ցույց տվի եւ դեսակ ինչպես թուրքական գողմեն գրնփակոցեն որ քեսաբը մեմեւս որ ժողովրդին վախի մեջ պահեն եւ որովհետեւ ապրիլ 24-ի commemoration-ի հիշատակի Orbidilla, Abrikasan Shorsa, Avasi Kaki, Machurum Peregreden. Jamanagega were Poloret Herasinek, IT workers, says the V, War of Garevor Harsasiga. You watch them, Garevore, Amenin breaking news, Shat Garevor Harsmanasiga. You have I saw Vorovedev, Abrikasan Shorsa, Yergo or Verche, Anshuste, I said Gor Verch, Polorit Karachargen, Polor Suiserum Masnaksek, Manavan. Թուրքական տեսմանադան արչև ժամը 12-ին որ պիտի սկսվի Pan Pacific Park-ին բոլորը հոնդեղ եղեք ներկա ժամը 11-ին եւ անդեղեն պիտի քալվի Մեուգես Մալթեբի թուրքական տեսմանադուն հոնդեղը պիտի փողոքի ցույց մղելա Այո, ճիշտ է, որ մեկ օրով չի լուծվիր այս հարցերը, բայց մեր ցայնը մեկ օրն ալ պետք է բարձրացնենք, ամեն օր պետք է բարձրացնենք, ես այդոր համաձայն եմ, բայց կոնեմ այդ օրը, եթե երևելի լան, որովհետև որ լսած եմ, 25 տարբեր գազմագերբություններ անդեղը ներգավիրը լան, օդար գազմագերբություններ, հայերա պետք է լան, ինչպես որ անցյալին 160 000 հայեր եկան, այս անգամ թոնինը լա, բոլորով քաչալարված քացեք այդտեղը այդ ցույցին. Ուրեմն, որ մենք մեր ցայնը բարձրացնենք եւ ճշտամին չի դեսնա, որ մենք թուլացած ենք, ինգած ենք, մորցած ենք, այս կարևոր դպավորություններ գցքե ճշտամին վրա, որ հայը միացած է եւ պայքարի պատրաստ է միևնույնս։ Congressman, because the first genocide of 19th century, the Armenian genocide, which took place under the Ottoman Empire, later in Young Turks, it started in 1800s actually. We right now see the same situation in United States, where unfortunately members of Muslim Brotherhood infiltrating into the State Department, taking control. I want to be honest and speak on open air. And they're
Just talked to someone right, who works with the government. Told you this.
They're promoting more Islamic ideology instead of Christian, so they want to suppress and stop Christianity and prosecute Christians. One of them happens to be you.
That's right.
Which you stood for your rights, conservative rights, Christian rights, and you helped people of Middle East in the past as a Foreign Affairs Committee member. Right. You went there, you traveled there, you saw the oppressed people, you helped them, right, in 2014.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
And right now we see the same situation here in the United States, unfortunately.
Right, and I'm not going to go into all the details, but if anybody has legal experience, or if you have a background in doing background research, or if you can contribute to a fund that I don't control, I wish they would email me, because this is another way. Again, the show is about taking action, and it's another way you can help me and help defend Christian rights and Christian brothers and sisters who are under persecution. You and I were talking earlier.
Right.
I had a friend who actually was in California, and he had to leave because the government came down again and again and was just harassing him.
Right.
Because he was running a Christian camp. Our government, United States government, is increasingly hostile to those, and you see some of these even up in Berkeley, where you're having people with spray dressed in black, like
yep,
fascists themselves, beating up people that want to speak out. Again, if you look at the history of the world, being silent is the worst thing to do.
Right.
So if you could give out that email address, it's newsbreakfox02.
Right, I will
Newsbreak
do that.
Newsbreakfox02, yeah.
I will do that in a few minutes.
Yeah, but I need some assistance, and if you can help me, that'd be great. I can't, you know, I'm indigent. The government in 3.5 years have taken quite a bit of my money. So, but if you also get a hold of our host and let him know, that'd be great. So there's a lot of different ways you can get involved. I'm excited that this show is going from a passive, or not
right,
passive, but it, as we're going to commemorate the murdering of people, I think it's good that we remember them by taking action for today.
I agree with what says.
Hello.
Hi, Aram Etzek.
Խնդրեմ, կարելի խնդրեմ ձեզ պարոն Բեդրոս Հաջյանին խնդրեք, որ հերուստացույցից մեկ էլ այդ համարը հայտարարի, որտեղ չկարողացանք գրեյը առնենք։
Սիրով, հիմա գնեմ, հիմա գսեմ, այո։
Շնորհակալ եմ ձեզ։
Ուրեմն, հերախոսի թիվը միևնույնս ասեմ, 202-647-6575, 202 էրիակոդ 647-6575։ Եթե գրնանք այդ վիդեոն, մենք միևնույնս ցույց տանք, եթե կարելի է, եթե գրնանք այդ վիդեոն, ցույց տանք, կներեք այսօր տելեֆոնից շատ կտանգով, որով Քեսաբեն հերացայներ գուկագոր, շոյեն վերջ պիտի պատասխանեմ նորեն, ուրեմն հերախոսի թիվը 202-647-6575 հերախոսի թիվն է State Department-ին, պետք է բոլորդ հերացայնեք և քանքադիկ, Քեսաբի վրա ռմբակոծում կա, գրնանք այդ վիդեոն, մենք միևնույնս տնենք։ Այս ռմբակոծումը, որ գլա ջիհադիստները, ասի հայկական գողմը չէ նկարած, իրենք նկարած են և հպարդությամբ ցույց կտան, որ Քեսաբը կռմբակոծեն, որ ահավասիկ տեսեք սիրելիներ, և իրենց Ալլահին պրեզներ կնեն, որ մեմևս աս անմագարտակ ժողովուրդը, հերախոսի թիվն է 202-647-6575, հայի վրա ամեն գոմեն հարցագում կա, ժողովուրդ բոլորի կողմեն հարցակում հատոր համար մեզ պետք է միապանություն եւ միապանության մեջ պետք է քանկադինք այս State Department-ին եթե մենք մեր ցանը չի բարձրացնենք իրենք իրենք մի չի գեցնեն ասիկա ասի մի չառնակվի թիշ պախտապար դեսեք վիդեոն եւ գանցնեմ խոսելու
Also get who you talk to write it down who you talk to and what they said to you say that in there
Yes after the video
Oh you sure I didn't know
Ավասիկ դեսնակ քաղաքի վրայի հրտիրները որ թափածեն քյուղի վրա Կեսաբն է ասիկա Կեսաբի վրա դեսնակ ինչպես գրմփագոցումներ գլագոր ասիկա այս օրն է 3 ժամ առաջ Եվ ինձ անդեղ մի քանի հերացայիններ եկան եւ որովհետեւ հիմա TV-ի վրա եմ չեմ գտնար բանասանը չեմ ուզեր TV-ով խոսի մասիկա բայց բոլորիդ մի դերակացնեմ Facebook-ային հարցերով այսօր մի չառնակենք մեր հաղորդումը Steve Stockman-ի հետ որով առաջ հայերենով փաստադրեմ Steve I want to explain in Armenian what you have done Ice Congressman-ը եղած է Foreign Affairs-ի ղեկավարը նախակահը կացած է Middle East 2013-2014 այդ բաժինները որ քրիստոնյաներն են եւ բավականին օգնած էր քրիստոնյաներուն այդտեղը այդ ժամանակին եւ որ սլաթեր գլային քրիստոնյաները այսպիսի церկի մեջ որովհետեւ այս անստավորությունը իսկական աշխատած է ազատամիտ ջիհադիստ իսլամ օբամային թեմ ադոր համար այսօր իրեն վրա շատ մեծ հարցակումներ կա եւ ադոր համար այսօր պետք ունինք մենք միապանվելու իրեն գողքը որովհետև այսպիսի բարդիկ մեզ համար թանգակին են եւ մեր ասկի համար թանգակին եւ կարեւոր անստավորություններ են եւ ինքը ոչ թե միայն գվախնա խոսելու այլ պայքարի մեջ եղած է միջև այսօր եւ ադոր համար մենք պետք է իրեն օգտակար դառնանք ամեն ինչով որովհետև վերջիվերջո այստեղ կա քաղաքապարախոսական խավարի եւ լույսի պայքարը եւ երբ որ լույսի որդիները կզառնվին բادرազի մեջ Պետք է լույսի ворթիներու եղբայրները ոդկի կանգնեցնեն եւ ոչ թե նահանջեն։ Այսինքն այս լուրերու մեջ մենք լսենք ամեն տեսակի լուրեր։ Steve I want you to explain the what are the accusations? It's very mind-boggling they would accuse somebody of that.
Well, it's three and a half year investigation.
Right.
They maybe next one of the shows we can show. I was on TV and I called for. I had Ted Nugent come. I blocked the gun bill and the immigration bill. I tried to arrest Lois Lerner. I tried to impeach Eric Holder. And so at some point they got mad. And
so you went after the big fish.
Yeah,
let's put it this
right,
way.
Yeah. And my colleagues told me not to
do it. Well, let's put it this way. You went out after the big communist Islamic fishes.
Yeah, you have. Obama is, as you know, you talked to someone, a friend of mine who works for the government. He filled his government with people, or several people, very high levels with the Islamic Muslim Brotherhood, which, right. by the way, even Egypt and other nations declared it a terrorist organization. So did you know? So, I mean, even Muslims say it's a terrorist organization, and here we had them in our government. So anyhow, I was very aggressive, and in turn, the president was very aggressive against me and spent 3.5 years investigating me. And some lawyers are saying that this is horrendous and it looks more political. And so I have to defend myself. And as you saw, John Stossel talks about how the Obama administration has turned many of these agencies into a political weapon.
Right.
And I have to defend myself really with both of my hands behind my back. They have unlimited funding. They have unlimited number of attorneys. And so I'm asking for two things, one for support and two for prayers are really vital at this time. And we can give continuous update what's happening. And,
Absolutely.
And,
and meanwhile, you are fighting for the indigenous people of Middle East. You are still standing firm on Turkish atrocities against the Armenians.
And also I work with a medical hospital in the Middle East. I also met with the Coptic Pope and other things.
Right.
I am very, and we have an opportunity to make relations better, but we had a government under President Obama who sided, it seemed like every chance he had, he sided with the wrong side. This included working against many of the Middle Eastern countries. It was a crazy policy. I hope Trump doesn't repeat everything that's gone on so far, but I think he's at least opened the door to where we can stop some of this Muslim Brotherhood stuff.
And Trump, it was very disturbing to see Trump call Erdogan, which no president ever called him, and congratulated him, terrorist, yeah. A dictator, basically.
Well, Obama said it was his favorite president in the world, and he used to call right. Erdogan frequently, but I don't know. I don't know Trump's position on that. Why it was? Maybe he's trying to, you know, Trump's very much a negotiator. Maybe he's trying to get something in return, like what he did with Egypt, where he reached out to Assisi and he got back an American prisoner. So right. I don't know if this is part of his way to reaching out. But right now we're in a critical stage. We have one of our largest military bases there, and he just gave him a week ago today, I think it was last week. He just, Erdogan had just basically got him voted in, same thing, by the way, Adolf Hitler did, voted himself into one-man rule.
Right.
It's horrible.
Referendum, which was he made himself the Pope, let's put it, the pontiff.
No, it's more than the Pope, it's a dictator.
Right, dictator.
But isn't that a definition for a dictator is?
Yeah.
Right. When you vote yourself in?
Yeah. Right. Well,
so people don't have to say so, but yet we're saying Assad is the dictator versus Erdogan.
To me, Assad is not a dictator. The dictators are Aliyev and second dictator, the biggest dictators are Aliyev and Erdogan.
Correct.
Hi, Herametsek. Herametsek?
Hello, hi. I just like to thank you, both of you guys.
Thank you.
And I just try to speak English.
Sure.
Because, you know, yeah, when we're talking about Trump, we graduate to Erdogan and... It's something is going to happen. He's not graduating just like that. You know Trump. He don't like people like that. He's going to do something. You never know what he's going to do because I think, you know, he's, I don't know. I think he's going to do something. He's graduating, but he's not meet anything.
We will see.
Yeah, I hope he's going to do something. Turkey, whatever, he's gonna defend us. I know. Let's see. Who knows?
All right.
Thank you very much for your call. And let's not forget to call the number for because they're bombing Kessab again. A few hours ago, they started bombing on the eve of commemoration. 202-647-6575 is the department, State Department's number, where you can basically call and complain. I think it's on the...
Yeah, it's up there.
It's up there. Call that number and put a complaint that Turkey, from the other side of the border, from Turkish side of the border, they're bombing. Türkagan գողմեն ռմբակոծումնեն և ասոնք պեն Թուրքիս Թուրքերնեն, որոնք Քեսաբի վրա մեմի եվս հարցագում ռազեն և գրմբակոծեն առանց կենալու և կիտնալով, որ ապրիլ 24-ի commemoration-ի օրն է ապրիլ 24-ի.
And be respectful.
Right.
Yeah,
right. And watching that video was very disturbing on one thing.
Right.
Was that these are very large artillery, RPG-like missiles that are flying into middle of towns, homes, civilians.
Heading
it's not
anywhere.
Specific
right.
targets, yes. just uh-huh. anywhere. So you want to talk about mass murders. This is what Turkey's doing, is just shelling these massive explosions into Kessab, where there's innocent people who are sleeping, who are awake, who are just up and about, hiding, whatever it is. And it's very disturbing that nobody from any other international leaders have stood up and said, what are you doing? You know, we need to stop this because this is a terrorist act now. This is another country who basically entered into another country's territory and bombing randomly. This is an act of war. Basically, if Syria wants to declare, and Russia hopefully wants to declare, this is a declaration of war on Turkey because of...
On Syria.
No.
From Turkey.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. But Syria and Russia can now declare war on Turkey because of what they're doing.
Right. I don't know if Russia would ever do that. That's another question.
They
but
won't.
Syria can.
Right.
Unfortunately, I don't know if they want to do that because we see innocent people are being killed. Innocent people's
Correct.
Lives are in danger.
Correct.
And on the contrary, we see jihadists, terrorists openly, not secretly, videotaping themselves and praising their God, which his name is Mungat, Allah. I don't know who the heck is that. But and throwing bombs on innocent people in the name of their God. Which God allows this? I don't understand. Whose God allows this? So their Allah and our God is not the same. Get it into your heads from now on. Yeah. It's not the same.
Correct.
Anybody that kills people in the name of God, that's not a God. That's a sadistic demon, unfortunately.
Let's By the way, there's way. Another person. I don't know, we don't have the number handy, but Chris Smith, he actually is very sympathetic, and he chairs the Committee on Human Rights.
Right.
And he would be an excellent person who actually will call you back a lot of times.
Where does he work at?
He's a congressman from New Jersey. He actually got elected during, ironically, Abscam.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. So, and he's pro-life. He was head of the New Jersey pro-life. And he is a tremendous guy. He's been there since, I think, 79. Mm-hmm. He's actually got some health issues right now. But he's another person, if you can look his number up, it's Congressman Chris Smith. He also is very influential with the State Department.
Right. And, you know, we were not thinking about talking about Kessab at all. We were thinking about Christian prosecution, genocide, your issues. But all of a sudden, breaking news came about 1 hour ago,
And
we had to inform the people.
By the way, let me ask you a question. Christians were murdered in the beginning under Romans, right?
Right.
How many Christians, when is the peak of the time that Christians were murdered?
I could say 1900s during the Armenian Genocide.
Actually, now they're saying that the peak is coming now again.
One more time, yes.
I mean, they wiped them out in Iraq.
Right.
They wiped them out.
ISIS took them slaves, killed them a few years ago while Obama was sitting in office playing golf. He didn't care. He was playing golf while Christian women were being raped.
Well, not just raped, killed.
I mean, right, burned, killed.
I think the entire population of the Christians in Iraq are gone now, and those are some of the most
historic.
Correct. I mean, they spoke Aramaic.
Right.
I mean, these are they've been around quite literally for millennial. It is.
And we go on again. You know, I want to ask you a question. During your term when you were at Congress, you did acknowledge the genocide. You did speak about the genocide.
Yeah,
I want you to elaborate.
Well, here's the thing that we need to understand. There are people in Turkey who agree with the fact that there was a genocide. And unfortunately, we need to make alliances with those people.
Those that agree.
Yeah, there's too often everybody says, well, you're from the blue camp, you're from the red camp, you're not this, you're not that. But the common denominator was, we're going to acknowledge it. Right. And one of the things I failed and I wish we could have done is to get the Armenians and those in Turkey who sympathize, which, by the way, a lot of the Kurds do, too.
Right.
Get them together in a unified voice. You know, you can take a light and it doesn't do anything. But if you concentrate that light, it's a laser and it can cut steel. Well, same thing. If you take people from different parts, we could have got them together. The Turks, the Muslim Turks who agree with the genocide that it happened, the Kurds who agree that it happened, and the Armenians working together and elevate this issue and also create some kind of, which you and I talked about. I really want to get it to, you know, we have the Israeli Jewish Holocaust where people can see what happened. There's nothing like that I know of anywhere in Washington where you can go in and see that.
For the Armenians.
Right. And I think that needs, education is so important. You and I were talking about this before. The Kuwaitis had a situation where they were all wiped out by Saddam Hussein, and other peoples had similar circumstances. The Vietnamese had their boat people. But if you stay quiet, your history's lost. And I'm shocked, just shocked at the fact that Armenians are so quiet about what happened. They need to speak up more. And this is something that's really, frankly, disturbed me, is how everybody's so quiet. You know, if I can speak up, you're happy about that. But it's more important that you speak up about it, because I'm not Armenian. You are Armenian. You should speak up. And being silent is more of a crime than doing nothing is more of a crime than almost it's helping out the genocide by not speaking up.
Hi, Hiram Metzek. Hiram Metzek.
Hi, Paris.
Paris says.
Պարոպետրոս, ուզում է իմ անային առաջի հերթին, որ զանգենք ենտեղ, ինչ կպոխի, եթե զանգենք ու խոսանք.
Որ չատ, որ մարդ հերաց այն է, շատ պան կպոխի.
Այո, ու երկրորդը, ում պետք է հասնեսի, պրեզիդենտին պետք է հասնես խոսքը
թե։ Ասի State Department-ին պիտի հասնի, State Department-ին թիվն է.
Այո, and I want to say thank you to Matthew, because he's always involved with Armenian stuff. Thank you, Matthew.
Thank you, man.
So much.
Thank you.
So, հերախոսի թիվերը արինք սիրեն էր, այս հերախոսի թիվերը, որ գտեսնակ, որ հերացայնեցեք Քեսաբի վրայի հարցագումի համար, ռմպագոզման համար ձեր կանկադը ներգայացուսեք, և որ անշուշտ է առանց դկետ խոսկերով ասելու, շատ պլայտ, որ այսպիսի հարցագումը Congressman Steve Stockman ասավ, թուք եք պիտի պարձասնեք ձեր ձայնը այս հարցերու վրա, և թուք պիտի կանգադիք, հայերը չինեն, օդարը լուրջ ունենար և չի էդա կրքրի վիրան, ինչպես որ միրիլիստի մեջ ծեղասպանությունի որ եղավ, օդարնե talk about that for the past, that's why you came here, we needed to talk about that, but there was this breaking news right here. You were behind conservatives, you right. encouraged the conservatives, they invited you from one camp to another, conservative camps, to direct them with the election, etc. You're the man behind the scene, and basically they want to take the man behind the scene down. That's what it is. The public needs to know that.
Yeah,
you know.
I taught campaigns, and I was very aggressive on the Hill. And Obama's an individual that takes things very personal.
I right.
Mean, you probably pick up on.
You're
that.
The one who wanted to impeach Obama, right?
Yeah, I was the first one.
Right.
I should have joined that.
Right. Yeah. and the fact is that he has demonstrated repeatedly that he goes after the people that he feels is an intrinsic threat to him. And
is it the king of this country?
Well,
no, it's because he has a lot of things to hide in his closet, so don't worry about that part.
So basically, now they came up with a theory that you did work for some nonprofits.
Right.
Is that okay to speak?
Yeah, I can to some degree, but I don't want to get too much
right.
because I'm getting into gray area.
Right.
But, they are accusing me of quite a bit of stuff, which. A lot of terms I looked at, it looks like it's over the top, I guess
right.
the best way. In fact, if they used the standard on me and it made it applicable to Hillary, she you know, she did it in spades and more so. So I think what needs to happen is that if we can get help from the community in numerous ways, and just shoot me an email if you're able to help.
Right. I will.
What kind of help do you need?
Well,
Steve.
I need legal support. Now, I can't do this. I can't do that. But I also need some support in terms of, because they took away my job and other resources. I need help with that area. So we can put out an email and let you email me if you can help. I'd greatly appreciate that.
So the email is newsbreakfox02
right.
at yahoo.com.
Right.
Գրնակ կանգրսմենին իմելն եք, newsbreakfox02@yahoo.com, անոնք որ գուզեն վերջի իմելն էլ, ես գրնամ նորեն դալ այս իմելը, you can call me this number anytime, and I can forward you the email, and we can go from there. If you want to assist congressman and show your support, you can email him, and he can tell you how we can proceed this. So because finally, he's been the voice of the conservatives, he's been the voice of the Christian rights, he's been the voice of behind when they wanted to ban the guns, he was against it.
Right.
So he's been the voice of the people, constitutional. And all of a sudden, they want to take those that speak on behalf of our freedom away and replace it with communists.
But they also did this to other people
right.
in Congress.
Right.
Dr. Paul Brown and some others They also, even our governor of Texas, they're in the presidential election.
Yes, they tried to take him down.
Yeah, yes. They deliberately did that. Time delay. So there's many people before me that went through this. I think Tom DeLay told me in all he spent $12 million in 12 years.
To protect
yeah,
himself.
Yeah, and that's why a lot of people don't want to run for office, because if you do the right thing, there are people out there that want to undermine you.
So basically there are forces in the government that they want to take down this country.
Oh, they're doing
they
want to
destroy the Constitution.
Yeah.
And they want to impeach those that are working to build America. Is that what can we say?
That's exactly right. In fact, it's funny because they call it the resistance and the conservatives call it the deep state.
Right.
It's the same people. They're working with inside the government that Obama appointed to undermine them. And you see it every day with Trump. The thing that's hilarious is that for 8 years, they never ever did any comedic jokes. You didn't see anything like that on Saturday Night Live.
Correct.
And you didn't see any newspapers hold them accountable, and now all of a sudden they're going back, oh, we're going to start doing this again. They're even talking about his immigration policy. My goodness, he hasn't dusted off the furniture. How could he implement an immigration policy? I just don't understand it.
Right. The immigration policy didn't come from Trump.
No, but they're accusing him of all these things. I thought, my goodness, it's just bizarre. So there are people. I think you should pray for Trump, too, because, frankly, they're going to try to do what they did to me to Trump. They're going to try to take him out, take him to court. In fact, he's already being sued.
Correct.
By many. So I think you're going to see as we go on here, the heat's going to keep turning up. And somebody, and I believe Soros, is funding. Those instant demonstrations are very expensive to organize.
And they're paid demonstrators.
Some of them are, some aren't. I mean, there are people there that get on Facebook or whatever and see it and join it. And they don't know what. I personally don't think they understand the broad implications, but it's undermining democracy. Remember, during the debate, Hillary asked Trump, if I win, are you going to accept it? And I don't know if Trump ever gave an answer, but Hillary certainly said, if you don't accept it, then it undermines democracy. And that's exactly what she's doing.
Yes, if you don't accept it, it undermines democracy,
yeah.
But then she doesn't accept
exactly.
It. Exactly. Ayo Rametsek? Yes?
Hello.
Ayo Rametsek?
Parirgun.
Parirgun.
Ուրեմն բարոն Բեդրոս Հակակներ ձեր բոլորին
եւ
ես ասում ունեմ որ ինքնից վրա սպաս տավ եւ զարգացած է այս մոտ 6 տարի է սուրիացիները մանավանդ հալեվի ժողովուրդ հալեվ կեսապ ընդանուր շատ քեֆ վիճակի մեջ են եւ իմ ճարպկացած մեկ կետ մկա որ ինչու համար Թուրքի հայեր մանավանդ Ամերիկայի հայեր որ բոլորը կարողություն ունին քրեթե լանիցական լամենսով որ գնան օգնել իրական օգնել այսինքն գրագին հերացնել երբ որ փորձանք մգա այսինքն գրագին մեծ է ժողովուրդը առաջին հստակ օգնությունը գրագին հերացնել փոխանակ ուրիշ բաներով կանկադելու այսինքն հասնել նախակային կամ ուրիշ հարցերով ես իմ դաշնակով ավելի լավ է որ նախ գրագին հերացնել չամներեն բոլոր հայերը վեճ մտածենք նայք ինչ գտնենք եւ ամենը հայերը եւ գնան են ամեն մեկի հյուրը մեջ գնա մի քանի ընտանիք նույնիսկ բախել ըստ շրջանի համար
շատ լավ հարցումս է ես ցեզի
հարցումս եմ ադե որ պատասխանը երբեք չեմ կտած եւ ցավով գտեմ ասես շատ մեծ ցավով
ես շատ լավ ես պատասխանը դամ ադոր վրա ես եթե գիշեք 2013-ին 14-ին հայդարարություններ ըրի եւ մի քանի անձնավորություններ ուզեցին օգնել բայց եղան դժբախտաբար չարախոսներ որոնք սկսան հայդարարել որ Թրամ գարնվի հոստեղեն ոնդեղեն հարյուրավոր հազարավոր դոլարներ գարնվի որ անցամբ ես 1 դոլար ովևէ մեկեն չեմ առած ովևէ մեկ չեմ առած մի քանի խարթախ անձնավորությունները սկսան հայդարարել սուտ բաներ Ադոր համար ես անցամ մեկ կողմ քաշվեցա, որովհետև գիտեք, փամփասանքը վիրավորանք է։ Ադոր համար ես չուզեցի շարնակել։ Գաբերը գային, ես մեմ եւս սկսեմ։ Գաբերը գային, որ օգնեն գաշ ժողովրդին, եւ մեծ գաբեր գային, եւ մեծ ցերկեր գային մեջը։ Բայց դժբախտաբար, որովհետև փամփասող փերաններ գային, ես մեկ կողմ քաշվեցա անցամ եւ չուզեցի օկտագարթանալ, որովհետև դեսա որ փամփասանքը շատ ծանր էր։ Եվ քան այդպեսի փամփասանքներ որ սուտ էին որ Թրամ գարնվի, այսպես գարնվի, քողություն գլա, սուտ-սուտ տարածայնություններ եղան։ Ես իմ սիրտս նորեն գցավեր, բայց պարտապար պետք է մեկ կողմ քաշվեի, որովհետև դեսա, որ կան ուժեր, որոնք ուզեցին այդ ժողովուրդը չարչարվի այդ երկրի մեջ և դարբեր երկրներում մեջ։ Այդ ուժերը թշպախտապար մեծ մասով հայ ղեկավարներ էին, աշչաբով ուզեմ ասեմ, եւ ադիգա ցավալի է ասելը։ Հիմա անցնենք մեր հաղորդումի շարունակությանը անգլերենով, որովհետեւ մեր հյուրը ամերիկացի է։ I want to explain a little bit what's going on with your situation. Steve եղած է conservative ամերիկացի congressman, foreign affairs-ի նախակահը միացյալ նահանգներու կոնգրեսի եւ հիլի մեջ աշխատած է որպես շատ մեծ ցերկ եւ State Department-ի մեջ շատ մեծ հարկանք ունի։ Տիշպախտապար գրեստանք, որ իրեն թեմ եղավ մեծ հարցակումներ, ինքը գա կոյավեդեվե եւ պիտի թեր աշխատի եւ ինքը հայկական հարցով գուզե շատ մեծի օգտակար դառնալ։ Ադոն համար, եթե գուզեք կապնվել Ստիվին հետ, գրնակ ինձ հերացայիններ էսեզի իրեն իմել ու գտամ, գրնակ անցամբ հետը կապնվել եւ տեսնալ ինչպես կրնանք իրեն սուպորտենենք, որովհետև ցախագոմյան կոմունիստները, կոմունիստական ջիհադիստները, իսլամները մեծ ծևով իր վրա աշխատին, որ դաբալեն, ինչպես որ դաբալած են շատ-շատ ուրիշ մարդոց, որ ինգացնեն։ Եվ ես կրնամ ասել մեկ բան իրեններ, գիտեմ որ հայկական հարցը շատ բարեկամներ ունի, ինքը այդ բարեկամներեն մեկն է, աշչապ կրնամ ասել։ And Steve, I want to ask you, you said in few words about the hill. Can you explain to the people what is the hill?
Yeah, I apologize for using vernacular.
I had to say why they're after you, because I said those evil forces, the jihadists, the communists are trying to...
Well, you have a battle, and you're seeing the battle take place now even more publicly.
Right.
But that battle has been going on for many years.
Right.
And I was praised at the time as being very brave, and my colleagues said I was, was going to be attacked. And I said, no, this is America, this isn't third world. Well, it's third world. And they have taken stuff that normally, in my opinion, they should have sent a note saying, hey, there's a mistake on your income tax,
right,
change it. Instead, they said, we're gonna throw the book at you. So
things you didn't even know.
Yeah, and they usually send you a letter or some kind of notification.
Issues you didn't know. Basically, it shows they can set up somebody and execute.
Well, there's actually a book called actually a book called Three Felons a Day,
right.
And they even figured out. They said how to indict Mother Teresa.
Right.
So, and then as you saw earlier, there's a book I'm trying to remember called Lies Within the DOJ, and they convicted Ted Stevens, who ultimately died, and then after they convicted him, they found out that he wasn't guilty. Same thing for Arthur Anderson, where they accused Arthur Anderson, I think it was Arthur Anderson, they were taking saying they're throwing all the documents out, which turned out not to be true. So you're in a battle. We don't battle against flesh and blood, but principalities. And we're definitely in this country right now in for a fight for the heart and soul of this nation. And you folks that came over here and fled oppression, either from communism or from dictatorships, you're watching a repeat of what happened in some of your nations, and you can't be silent this time. You cannot be silent. You have to stand up. Help me, also help the cause overseas right now. That's alarming that someone unilaterally just shoot indiscriminately.
Kessab, yes.
Yeah, this is a battle, and I ask you to help me, but I also want you to help our friends right now who are being shelled and killed. You know, I may get in trouble and go before court and all that, but we have real people sitting at home, and those shells are actually a lot larger than RPGs. They're big shells. They'll kill a lot of people.
Right. Let's go to the phones. Ayo hrametsek.
Uzem Bedros.
Ayo hrametsek.
Կխնդրեմ մեկ բան մգարտացի բարեկամներուն քաչալերեր. Good evening, sir. Thank you very much for your with us feeling. I advise only one thing. Somewhere I read 1965 in East Coast of United States. In this placard I read, whoever he does, sooner or later he is going to pay for it. This civilized century, so high-tech century, they are not able to understand this. One day they must pay for it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Not on this earth,
in the other
earth. Next life.
Yeah. Right. I think, Matthew, you had to say something.
I did, and Steve, my apologies for what's taking place for you. It's horrendous that our democracy, that our Constitution, the people who fight for our Constitution, that our founding fathers have founded here, and to diminish and to disable and to prosecute or whatever it is, people who believe in the Constitution, people who believe in the Bill of Rights, people who believe in what America stands for, you know, we have dictators in our country who sit in a White House that pretend that they're for democracy, but they're rulers. And that is a heartbreaking and an alarming situation has taken place that not a lot of people have the guts to say on live air, but we need to call it what it is at this time, because what's taking place is they're trying to silence people who are trying to fight for humanity, for human rights, for Christianity, and for freedom. And for them to silence people over and over and over, but why didn't... Here's what bothers me. Hillary Clinton murdered people. She has blood on her hands. And she can run for presidency, but people who are fighting for a good cause to keep our Constitution, they get prosecuted, and that's a major problem. So my investigation firm, my personal self here, will offer the services to whatever you need or your defense team needs at your disposal.
Oh, thank you.
And we will be asking for local, my office is in Pasadena, we'll be asking locally for any volunteers who have experience in investigations or research to work out of our office to work this.
Well, thank you very much.
I just want to say quickly, Matthew, thank you so much. That means a lot to me. Right now, we're both our hands tied behind our back. I obviously can't afford it, and your gracious offer to help the attorney. We'll try to follow all the guidelines, make sure we follow what the government wants us to do, and I really appreciate it.
Well, thank you guys for coming. Thank you, Steve, for coming all the way from Texas.
Y'all.
We will be here for a few days. And thank you, Matthew, for being with us.
Thank you.
We will, before you leave, we will try to do one more episode of program. Thank you for being here one more night.
I want to say, too, no one ever thanks him. You've done a fantastic job. You're letting people know information is the most important thing. Power is information. Information is power. And what you're doing here today is a tremendous help in making people realize just how drastic we need to get involved.
Thank you very much. And Michev Kashapat, Asvat Serporlori Hed. Սրահների համար շատ վճարելը ճիշտ